सीडी इज अ फुल फॉर्म ऑफ सीडी इज कॉम्पैक्ट डिवाइस. स्टोरेज कैपेसिटी ऑफ सीडी इज यूजुअली 700 MB और 750 MB. इट इज एन ऑप्टिकल स्टोरेज डिवाइस. ऑप्टिकल स्टोरेज डिवाइस सर्कुलर इन शेप. वन पार्ट इज वेरी शाइनी विच वी प्लेस वी नीड द सीडी ड्राइव टू प्ले द सीडीज. टू रीड द डाटा और टू राइट द डाटा ऑन सीडीज वी नीड अ सीडी ड्राइव. And to write the data also, we all need a special kind of software to write the data on it also. We need a special kind of software to write data on CD or DVD. Okay. And there are three types of CDs, CDR, CD-ROM and CDRW. Anybody who can tell me the difference between CD-ROM and CDR? Anybody in the class who can tell me the difference between CDR? CD-ROM.
Ma'am, yeah.
Okay. CD-ROM is compact disk read only memory. Yes.
Ma'am, in CD-ROM, we can just read the data. We cannot write on the CD. We cannot add some data. And in CDR, we can record the data and we can read it also.
Correct. CD-ROM is a pre-recorded CD in which we can only read the data. 7th B class, it's not your period, beta. Your next period. Hai. Why so many students are there in 7th B? 7th B class, your period abhi nahi hai. Yes, Aditya? What do you want to say? Rudra, your next period. Anji, next. Yes, bachche.
Ma'am, aap please note share kar doge aapne?
ये नोट्स व्हाई टू शेयर. दीज आर गिवन इन द बुक.
दीज आर
गिवन इन द बुक. यस बुक में है. बुक खोलो. ओपन योर
बुक. मैं ना ठीक नहीं था ना काफी दिनों से. मैं मीटिंग ही नहीं लगा पा रहा था तो मैं बिस्तर से अभी उठा.
मैम बेटा बुक पहले की है और ये चैप्टर्स हम पहले भी कर चुके हैं फर्स्ट टर्म में है ना.
ओके मैम
सेम चैप्टर्स हैं एंड दीज वी हैड डन इन द फर्स्ट टर्म आल्सो. 7th B class again, many students are joining at this period. Because beta, aapka next period hai. Treya, your next period is of computer. Ye nahi hai. Check karo timetable mein aapka kaun sa period hai. Again, one more student is there. Why so much confusion? Okay, CDR is a CD recordable, compact disc recordable. Recordable means that you can record on it only one time. Whether you use the full space, whether you use only 1 MB, whether you use only 2 MB, or a few space, half of the CD, or a few MBs of the CD. But if it allows you to record only once. You cannot rewrite on it. You cannot erase the data on it. But CDRW, that is a type of compact disk which allows you to read as well as to write again and again. But you cannot selectively erase the data. If you want to erase the data on CD, you have to erase the complete data. That also with the help of the software for reading and writing the data. That software can be provided by the Windows itself or it can be an independent software. Nero software was used usually to read and write the data, to write data on the CDs. Nero, R-E-N-E-R-O. That was used most commonly to write data on the CDs or to erase the data or to write, copy the songs or to copy the files or images on the CD. So CDR and CD rewritable, read RW. R, it will allow you to record the data only once. Rewritable allows you to read and write the data again and again, but you have to erase the complete data. Second, next is digital video disc. That is your DVD. That is the storage capacity is up to 4.7 GB to 17 GB. That is single layer and double layer. Okay, 220 times faster as compared to CD in reading and writing. Storage capacity is much more as compared to CD. Again, optical storage device. Look-wise, they are very similar. They are same, but storage capacity and the quality of the storage of the graphics and video is different. Now, DVD-R, again, CD-R, DVDs are of three types. DVD-R, digital versatile disc recordable. RW, rewritable, DVD-ROM, that is a read-only memory, that is the pre-recorded DVDs which are available in the market on which you can only read the data from which, but you cannot write any data on it, okay? Next is pen drive. Portable devices, small hai, everybody is using nowadays only pen drives because they are very easy to use, store a large amount of data as compared to CD or DVD. If DVD is having the capacity of only 17 GB, it is having the capacity of up to 1 TB, right? So it's small, very lightweight. You can easily put them in pocket. Corrupt hone ka chance kam hota as compared to CD and DVDs. You do not need a special kind of software to read or write the data. You can selectively read and write the data again and again. Aap select karke files ko erase kar sakte ho, select karke files ko copy kar sakte ho again and again. So they are very easy to use. You just have to plug in and use it. Costly as compared to CD and DVD, but usability much more than CD and DVD. Next is Blu-ray disc. It is again in similar to CD and DVD. They support higher resolution and more advanced video and audio formats as compared to DVDs. But Blu-ray disc technology gets its name from the blue violet lasers that are used to read the Blu-ray disc. And their storage capacity is 25 GB or 50 GB. That means single layer Blu-ray disc or double layer Blu-ray disc. So single layer will have 25 GB and double layer will have 50 GB. But again, we need the special Blu-ray disc drive to read or write the data on it. Okay. Next is memory stick. Memory sticks means memory cards, which we usually use in our digital phone, smartphones or digital cameras or music players, iPods, iPads, tablets, mobile phones, jitni bhi portable devices hai aapki. All the portable devices have the storage capacity. Instead of hard disk, we are having the memory card. Okay, to store the data, to store the content of your portable device. And its storage capacity ranges from 4 GB to 128 GB. And nowadays, we are having, I think, 256 GB is also available. Okay. Next is, any doubt in the storage devices? Anyone? Any doubt in any of the storage devices? Okay, next is input devices. What are the various input devices? Kaun-kaun se input devices use kiya aap logo ne? Anyone? Aryan? Yes, Arzu. What are the various input devices? Yes? Arzu, Aryan, Laksh?
Mem keyboard, mouse, microphone, scanner.
Scanner
and touch screens,
and barcode reader,
or
keyboard,
ma'am, touchpad,
touch screen, ho gaya.
Magnetic
graphic tablets, or
light pen,
trackball, or OCR, OMRs, MICR. What is OCR? What is OCR? OCR ki full form kya hai? Hai na? Okay, keyboard. What is the use of keyboard? All of you had used this, so you can explain it to me. What is the use of keyboard? What is keyboard? बहुत छोटे बच्चों वाले क्वेश्चन
है इनपुट टेक्स्ट
टू इनपुट टेक्स्ट ठीक है कीबोर्ड हैज अ कीज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ लेटर्स नंबर्स एंड अदर सिंबल्स दे आर यूज्ड टू टाइप लेटर्स नंबर्स एंड अदर सिंबल्स न्यूमेरिक कीज अल्फाबेट कीज फंक्शन कीज आर देयर एरो कीज आर देयर एंड दे आर नॉट ओनली यूज्ड टू गिव इनपुट ओनली इनपुट टेक्स्ट ओनली दे आर आल्सो यूज्ड टू गिव इंस्ट्रक्शंस टू कंप्यूटर आल्सो When you play games by using the arrow keys or some shortcut keys, that means your keys are giving instructions to the computer. They are not just for typing the text. They are also used for giving instructions to the computer. Mouse. What is the use of mouse? Jasleen?
Pointing device.
Jasleen, what is the use of mouse? Be attentive in the class and unmute yourself and give answers. What do you mean by mouse? What is the use of mouse? Yes, Jasleen?
A mouse is a
A mouse is a pointing device which is used to select various items, and it can be wired or wireless. Mm-hmm. It has a scroll button on it.
Okay, two or three buttons are there. One button is scroll wheel. It is used to control the movement of pointer on a screen, and pointer can be used to select the items by clicking on it by using the mouse. So mouse is a pointing input device which is used to select items on the screen by controlling the movement of pointer. It can have two or three buttons. It can be optical mouse, or it can be a ball mouse. Okay, and it can be wired or it can be wireless. With the wire, you can attach it with the computer, or with the Bluetooth device, you can attach it, you can use it wirelessly. Next is microphone. What is the use of microphone? Yes, Nitya? What is the use of microphone? If you are not giving answer, I'm going to remove it, or I'm marking absent today.
Microphone is used to input audio.
Input audio. Okay, it is used to capture your audio and input it into the computer in the form of electrical signals. It can be for recording purpose. It can be for the purpose of giving instructions to the computer in the audio form. Okay, it can be sometimes we want to type by only speaking. So we do not want to type with the help of keyboard. We are using some software which will convert our speech into the text. So we can use a microphone to speak the text that we want to type. We can give instructions to the computer in audio form, or we can use the mic to record our sound for some purpose, for some presentations or for some other purpose. Scanner. What is the use of scanner? Mitansh.
Scanner is a device. Scanner is a device used for scanning documents and creating them in electrical form of printed image.
The physical documents, we want to convert them into the digital documents, electric documents. So it is a device that creates an electronic form of the printed images, or that printed image can be any photograph, can be some text page, or any document that you want to convert into a digital form that can be used with the, that can be converted with the help of a scanner. It is like a photocopier machine. When we put a page on a photocopier machine, it creates a duplicate copy, but in a physical form. But scanner will convert that physical copy, physical document into the electronic form. So it is an input device that scans the documents, photographs, pages of text, and create the electronic version of the document that can be viewed and edited on a computer. So many types of scanners are available: handheld scanner, flatbed scanner, and drum scanner. Handheld scanner, which can be held in a hand, which we can hold in a hand and move the scanner over the some barcodes or some QR codes or some page or some photograph, and it will scan the document or convert the document into electronic form. Flatbed device is there. We just put on the paper, put a paper on it, and it will scan the document. Drum scanner, it is in the form of a rolling drum in which the paper will roll on that drum and it will be converted into the electronic form. Next is barcode reader. Barcode reader सबने देखा हुआ है. What is the use of barcode reader? What is the use of barcode reader? Parmeet?
It is used to read barcodes of the products.
It is used to read the barcodes on the products and enter information into the computer regarding related to that barcode. Barcode is used to, it is used to identify an individual object. ठीक है, हर object का जो barcode होगा that will be different. So it is used to identify an individual object, individual product, and the information regarding that product is stored related to that barcode. Jaise agar aapka student ID hai, student number, admission number hai, that is individual for each student. If you want to find the details of any student, we just need the admission number, we enter the admission number in computer and it will give me the full detail. Similarly, when the barcode scanner scans the barcode, so information regarding that product is displayed on the screen. So barcode is a used to identify a product individually. So used to read the barcodes printed on the product, it decodes the data contained in barcode and sends the data to computer. Related to the barcode, her barcode ke aage uski information stored hai. So when we scan the barcode, it checks the barcode and the related information, information related to that barcode is displayed on the screen. Next is OMR, optical mark reader, OMR. What is OMR? You use the OMR sheets. Yes, Simran, what is OMR? Simran, what is OMR? Optical mark reader. Why we use it? Again and again, I'm saying it. Please be attentive in the class and give answer. Okay, Laksh, what is OMR?
Ma'am, to read the inputs which are in punched form.
To read the input?
Which are in punched form.
Punched like, form. Beta, you get the OMR sheets to give answers to your competitive exams. To multiple questions aapke hote hain. To give answers to them, you need the OMR sheets. OMR sheets mein we mark the answers out of the various options, right? So OMR reader is a device which will read the marked answers from the OMR sheets. And correct answers are always already stored in the program. Already stored in the program of the software of the OMR, then it will match the input with the already stored result, and the questions which matches the answer which matches, they will give the points accordingly and deduct the point according to the wrong answers. So it is used to read the mark at the various positions in OMR sheets, mainly used to check the MCQs, mainly used to check the answers given in MCQs. So where we are having multiple options, we are just supposed to mark the correct answer and it will read the mark at the particular position. Agar wo us position pe us question ka mark nahi hai, so it will mark it as a wrong answer. So it will check the correct answer jo already usme feed hai with the input which is given by the OMR and accordingly mark the sheets. Next is OCR. Optical character reader. It is used to scan the printed document and convert it into the editable text. Editable text. Convert the characters into text. जो printed document है उसका text convert करके उसको convert करके उसको as a image scan नहीं कर रहा now. Now it is scanning it in the form of editable text. We can edit the text which we scan by using the OCRs. Okay. Next is MICR. MICR is magnetic ink character reader, which is used in the banks for processing of checks. For checking apne checks, agar apne checkbooks dekhi hai, check mein usually now checkbooks are printed. In mein niche aapke paas kuch code likha hota hai with the magnetic ink and they are used to check the authenticity of the check. Next is light pen. What is the use of light pen? Anyone? What is the use of light pen? Yes, Pranay, what is the use of light pen?
It is used to draw objects on the screen.
It is used to draw or point the objects directly on the screen. It is a pointing
pen like input device.
It is a pointing input device to draw on computer screen or to point to any displayed objects or to make the menu selections. Okay, next is output device, but there are many other input devices. Graphic tablet, you use, kaise use hota hai? What is graphic tablet? Yes, anyone who had used graphic tablet? Ya dekha hai kisi ne use karte hue? Yes. What is the use of graphic tablet? License
by the graphic tablet.
Bolo Simran. Yes, Simran.
Yes, ma'am. It enables the user to draw graphics.
Not only hand graphics, hand drawing. Okay. It is like a tablet.
Animations and graphics.
Animations, nahi. It is like a tablet, a piece of a slate, and we use a pen on that tablet to draw anything or to write anything. And whatever we draw or whatever we write on that tablet, that is displayed on the screen. That is displayed on the screen. Like it is used to capture the handwritten signatures. ठीक है, इट इज यूज्ड टू कैप्चर द हैंड रिटन सिग्नेचर्स और इट कैन बी यूज्ड टू ड्रॉ द ग्राफिक्स. Somebody is not comfortable with mouse. Yeah, kuch graphic designers jo hai, they are not using mouse to design the graphics. They are using the tablets. Because the pen is easy to use on the tablet. They use the pen on that tablet. Use continuously use for tablet ke upar, draw karne ke liye cheezon ko ya effects dene ke liye ya menus options ko select karne ke liye use karte hain. And whatever they do on that tablet, that is drawn in that application. Like Photoshop mein agar kuch graphics create karne hain. So instead of using mouse, you can use a graphic tablet. If you are good in art. If you are good in artwork, so you can use the graphic tablet to draw the graphics on Photoshop or in Animate. ठीक है, अदर जितने भी ग्राफिक्स के आपके सॉफ्टवेयर्स हैं, ऑन दो सॉफ्टवेयर्स यू कैन यूज द ग्राफिक टैबलेट टू क्रिएट द ग्राफिक्स, टू ड्रॉ द ग्राफिक्स, एंड द पेन दैट वी यूज ऑन द ग्राफिक टैबलेट दैट इज कॉल्ड स्टाइलस, दैट इज कॉल्ड स्टाइलस. टच स्क्रीन, अनदर इनपुट डिवाइस. Directly on the screen, we can touch and give the input or select the items on the screen. Okay, next is various output devices. What are the various output devices? Monitor ke ilawa, kaun-kaun si output devices use kiye?
Printer.
Printer. Huh?
Plotter.
Plotter.
Speaker.
Speaker.
Projector.
Projector.
Plotter.
Plotter. ठीक है? Monitor, also known as VDU. Full form of VDU?
Visual display unit.
Correct. Visual display unit. It displays the output on screen. Whatever work we do on computer, we see on the monitor. We see the result of our work on monitor. The picture on monitor is made up of thousands of tiny colored dots called pixels. Chahe wo aapki mobile ki screen hai, chahe wo aapki tablet ki screen hai, chahe wo aapke laptop ki screen hai, chahe wo aapke LED ki screen hai ya digital camera ki screen hai. All the screens, the pictures on those screens are made up of pixels. The more number of pixels on a screen, the more clarity of the pictures. Whenever we buy any product, like mobile phone bhi lene jaate, toh first of all, we check the PPI. What is PPI? What is PPI? Kabhi configuration?
Pixel per inch. Pixel per inch.
Pixels per inch. Pixels per inch. So whenever we want to buy some mobile phone, स्मार्टफोन लेने जाते हैं, सबसे पहले कॉन्फ़िगरेशन चेक करते हैं. अच्छा, मैम रैम कितनी है, स्टोरेज कैपेसिटी कितनी है, डिस्प्ले कौन सा है. देन आल्सो चेक पीपीआई. पीपीआई मींस पिक्सेल्स पर इंच. मोर नंबर ऑफ पिक्सेल्स पर इंच, दैट मींस मोर क्लैरिटी ऑफ द स्क्रीन. यस लक्ष
मैम.
मैम जैसे अब कोई जो डिवाइस है उसकी स्क्रीन 4K तक सपोर्ट कर रही है, तो उसके पीपीआई मतलब 2160 होंगे.
That doesn't ये हर एक मॉडल पे अलग अलग डिपेंड करता है. Some models are giving 4, जैसे मोबाइल में मैंने sometimes देखा 440 pixels भी है पर इंच पीपीआई भी है. So that depends on the model and the company of the mobile phone or the device which is providing you the product. So how many pixels per inch they are providing, that depends on the model of the product. ठीक है, 4K is the color.
PPI अलग होता है.
4K is the color mode. कि हाउ मेनी कलर्स इट इज सपोर्टिंग. ठीक है, एंड पीपीआई इज द नंबर ऑफ पिक्सल्स पर इंच. कि जितने ज्यादा नंबर ऑफ पिक्सल्स होंगे ठीक होएगा, दैट मींस पिक्चर की क्लैरिटी उतनी ज्यादा शार्प होगी. पिक्सल जितने कम होंगे पिक्चर्स की क्लैरिटी उतनी कम होगी. व्हेन वी ज़ूम इट तो पिक्चर उतनी ज्यादा फटनी शुरू हो जाएगी. ठीक है, पिक्सलेट हो जाएगी.
स्क्रीन रेजोल्यूशन अलग होता है.
स्क्रीन रेजोल्यूशन नो. Screen resolution bhi almost same hai. That is given you the total number of pixels width wise and height wise. Wo aapko total de raha hai ki total meri screen pe itne pixels hai. Pixels per inch is giving you per inch kitne pixel aa rahe hain.
Yes ma'am.
Okay. Okay, the picture on a monitor is made up of pixels. There are various types of monitors available. Older type is CRT, that is the cathode ray tube. Beta, bahut sari full forms hain, bahut sari types of devices hain. You are supposed to learn them. I hope all of you remember. Humne first term mein ye chapter kiya hua ek bar. So all the full forms and all the types, various types of monitors, various types of scanners, various types of printers, types of CDs. So all the types you are supposed to learn. Cathode ray tube, that is a older type of monitor, bigger size mein bahut big hai, generate heat also, and एलसीडी लिक्विड क्रिस्टल डिस्प्ले थिनर एज कम्पेयर टू सीआरटीज. Technology is different. Cathode ray tube mein we are having a big tube at the back of the screen, and LCD we are having a liquid crystal displays. Theek hai, TFT thin film transistors, plasma monitors, touch screen monitors, OLED organic light emitting displays, or simple LEDs that is a light emitting display. So thin film transistor, LEDs, touch screen, plasma monitor, they are the advanced form of monitors. They can be used for the graphic purpose also. Zyada tar jo graphic designers hai, they are using, theek hai, plasma monitors or other monitors jo aapke aate hain. Jisme display support jo hai, colors ka support aur pixels ka support zyada ho, so that they can create the graphics. Okay, now next is printer. Printer is also an output device that is used to give the physical printout of the output which we see on the monitor. Whatever we see on the monitor, whatever digitally we had created, I want to have the physical output of that on a paper. For that purpose, we will need the printer. Two types of printer, impact printer and non-impact printer. What is the difference? What is the difference between impact printer and non-impact printer?
Ma'am, impact printer touches the head of the printer and the paper, while yes, non-impact doesn't touch.
Correct. In impact printer, jo broadly hum de sakte hain difference, that is a impact printer, the head of the paper, jo header hai, aapka jo print karta hai, that touches the paper. And in non-impact printer, there is no such technology in which the header touches the paper. ठीक है, सो देर इज लेस नॉइस इन द नॉन इम्पैक्ट प्रिंटर एंड मोर नॉइस इन द इम्पैक्ट प्रिंटर. इम्पैक्ट प्रिंटर्स आर स्लोअर एज कम्पेयर टू द नॉन इम्पैक्ट प्रिंटर. क्वालिटी इज लेस एज कम्पेयर टू द नॉन इम्पैक्ट प्रिंटर. इम्पैक्ट प्रिंटर्स विल गिव लेस क्वालिटी, नॉन इम्पैक्ट प्रिंटर्स विल गिव मोर क्वालिटी. वट आर द एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ इम्पैक्ट प्रिंटर्स? वट आर द एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ इम्पैक्ट प्रिंटर्स? यस, एनी वन?
Them like line printer,
or line printer, dot matrix printer, or dot matrix, daisy wheel. All these are the examples of impact printers. So non-impact printers,
inkjet printer, and inkjet printer.
Thermal printer.
LED
is a type of display, that is a type of monitor. Okay, laser printer, inkjet printer, thermal printer, these are the examples of non-impact printers. Speaker, jaise mic hai, that is used to input your audio. Speaker is an output device that is used to listen to the music or sound of the computer, to have the output of the audio. So whatever audio we want to listen to the music, that means we are getting the output in the form of audio form, and that audio form output is given by the speakers. Okay, then we are having plotters.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, जो headphones और earphones हैं वो भी speaker की category में आएंगे.
Headphone is also an output device to listen to the, to have the output in the form of audio form. ठीक है, headphone is also type of speaker नहीं आएगा, headphone अलग से output device आएगी. Plotter is also a graphic output device that is used to create the large drawings on paper. It is similar to printer, like printer is giving the output on a small paper, A4 size or A3 size or A5 size. ठीक है, बट प्लॉटर इज एन आउटपुट डिवाइस दैट इज यूज्ड टू प्रिंट आउटपुट्स ऑन अ ह्यूज पेपर्स, लार्ज पेपर्स, एंड दे आर यूज्ड टू यूजुअली प्रिंट द ग्राफिक्स जो हमने क्रिएट करे हैं, पोस्टर्स बनाए हैं, बैनर्स हैं, एंड ऑल दीज आर दीज कैन बी प्रिंटेड बाय यूजिंग द प्लॉटर्स. Plotters use a pen, pencil marker, or another writing tool to draw the multiple continuous lines onto the paper rather than the series of dots like a traditional printer. So there are two types of plotters. One is pen plotter, second is photo plotter. Pen plotter, there are multiple pens are used to plot the, to draw the graphics on a paper. Okay, photo plotter is also a type of plotter which will print the graphics on paper. लास्ट डिवाइस इज प्रोजेक्टर. प्रोजेक्टर आपने सबने देखा है, आप यहाँ नीचे रूम्स में भी लगे हुए हैं. प्रोजेक्टर्स आर आउटपुट डिवाइस व्हिच इज यूज्ड टू टेक द डिस्प्ले ऑफ द कंप्यूटर स्क्रीन एंड प्रोजेक्ट द लार्जर व्यू ऑफ इट ऑन अ फ्लैट सर्फेस. कुड बी अ वॉल, इट कुड बी अ वाइट स्क्रीन, और इट कुड बी एनी स्पेशल काइंड ऑफ स्क्रीन व्हिच इज ऑफन यूज्ड इन मीटिंग्स और सेमिनार्स. So that the many, a large number of people can view the output which is given on the laptop screen or monitor screen. हम laptop सामने रख के meeting attend नहीं कर सकते. So whatever output we want, कि a large number of people should view it, whether in a meeting or whether it in a seminar halls or big auditoriums are there, and you want to display something on a large screen, you will need the projector that will take the output of the screen and project it on a flat surface so that a large number of people can view it. Clear? हाँ जी, clear है सबको? Any doubt in this chapter? Now we are left with the third chapter, that is the types of software that we will start from tomorrow. Okay, any doubt in this chapter you can ask me. Okay, that's all for today.